So, hi Tina, thanks so much for speaking to us. Could you tell us a bit about where you are and what you do?
Hello, Jill. Greetings from the Leprosy Mission Trust India. I'm Tina, and I live in a small city called Belgaum, which is in the state of Karnataka. This is towards the southwest of India. I've been with the Leprosy Mission India for the past 20 odd years now. I head the Sustainable Livelihoods and Community Empowerment Program. If I were to tell you about this program in a nutshell, I would say that it has broadly three aspects to it. One, it caters to vocational skills training for individuals affected with leprosy and other disabilities. Two, it facilitates livelihood opportunities for this target population, helping them to become economically empowered. And three, it promotes inclusion of these marginalized groups into their own communities, so that they can live a life of dignity and at par with other community members.
So can you give us an example of some of the vocational training courses that you offer?
If I were to give you examples, I would have to give you a bit of a background, Jill, because the students who come for the vocational training programs are from all sorts of educational backgrounds. Some of them are illiterate, many of them are school dropouts, and some have finished their formal schooling as well. So we offer a basket of different training courses. I mean, for the ones who have no education, we try to provide them with certain skills which will help them to be self-employed. So they would get into, say, organic farming. Some of them would learn mobile repairing or repairing of AC, air conditions and refrigerators. I mean, for the ones with a bit of education and who could get into employment, there are the tailoring skills, there is fashion designing. There are also some computer courses which certain school dropouts can actually pursue. For the ones who finish formal school education, we actually encourage them to get into formal training. These are recognized by the government of India. So they would get into engineering courses such as diesel mechanics or motor mechanics, or they can also get into formal computer courses which would actually help them get into offices and factories, etc. So the courses are, I mean, we have a wide variety of courses and they are specific to the needs of the individuals.
So how has the current situation affected the people that you support?
Well, if I were to look at the current situation, I would say that, I mean, things have come to what we used to call a normal life have come to a complete halt. I mean, it's been 50 days since the government of India has instituted the nationwide lockdown, and our programs have been gravely affected. I mean, the vocational training program caters to around 600 young boys and girls affected with leprosy and other disabilities. It's a residential program, but we've had to send those students back home. The government of India has told us to conduct online classes, but we've never done that before. It's something new for us. However, our instructors have equipped themselves and are on to taking classes online. But if I were to take a count of the 600 students who actually went back home, roughly 2/3 are only able to benefit from these online classes. And if I were to tell you the reason behind why the others are not able to avail of these classes, I'd like to talk to you about Ramesh. Ramesh is one of our students. He's affected by leprosy. Like the others, he too returned back home. His parents are daily wage earners, and they haven't been able to secure any sort of employment for the past 50 days. Besides Ramesh, they have five other family members. And I mean, when Ramesh went back home, he had an ulcer on his right foot. He was under treatment here at the Vocational Training Center. And we gave him 15 days of medicines and instructions of how to take care of his ulcer. But Ramesh lives in a very rural village. I mean, if the family background that I've told you, they wouldn't be able to afford a smartphone or a similar device which would help him get onto these online classes. An internet connection in his village is a far cry. There's no way that he'll get good internet connection over there. But the truth of the matter, Jill, is for Ramesh, these online classes right now are not important. His ulcer too is not important. What what is important is how he and his parents would be able to manage three meals a day for his entire family. Jill, I could go on and on with these stories. But the crux of the matter is that people are facing hardships. I mean, offices are closed, factories are closed, even shops have been ordered shut due to the lockdown. So many of our graduates who were employed too have gone back home. And they too are in a panic mode. There's a lot of, uncertainty about their employment as well. And you are aware how stigma and discrimination makes it so difficult for people affected by leprosy to seek employment and get on with life. And now with this lockdown, incomes have become inconsistent. And for some, they've stopped altogether. And people affected by leprosy have no savings to fall back on. Well, Jill, the crux of the matter is that for people affected by leprosy, their livelihoods are at risk. Yeah. And if they lose their livelihoods, it will be a struggle for them.
Here in Scotland, we can help by continuing to fight leprosy through donating. How important is it that we do that?
Jill, I'd like to thank the people of Scotland. They've been so generously supporting our programs. We at the Leprosy Mission are committed to reach out to people affected by leprosy, even during this time of crisis. And we are doing so too right now with whatever immediate relief and aid is possible. Once the lockdown is lifted, we hope to put all our efforts into bringing to speed the vocational training program and the livelihood program. I mean, there's a lot of retraining we'll have to do of people affected by leprosy so that they are well equipped to enter the job market. We'll also have to work with the graduates who have lost their employment, support their placements so that they can get back into employment. And there are many livelihoods that are lost. So we are committed towards restoring those livelihoods. At this point, Jill, I'd also like to talk about our residential facility that we offer to disadvantaged elderly people affected by leprosy who have been abandoned by their families. I mean, this service basically caters to their needs in a holistic manner, helping them to live dignified, healthy, and active lives. The people of Scotland have been supporting our livelihood program as well as this residential facility. And for many affected by leprosy, this is a lifeline for them. So this need is very crucial. And we hope and are confident that the people of Scotland will continue their support, and this support will multiply to many folks.
Thanks, Tina. It's really humbling and encouraging to speak to you. Thank you for your time.
Thank you, Tujil. Pleasure speaking to you.